Hello and welcome back to another of my episodes of PS Crafty DIY.
This time we are going to have a look at something different. That's right, it's a crashed Mavic Pro which I bought off Facebook Marketplace with a good intention to fix the poor fella and make it fly again. So let's quickly assess what's broken and what's not. As you can see, it's the camera gimbal assembly that took the most hammering here. The gimbal flat ribbon cable is torn off and needs replacing.
The camera signal cable does not look too clever either, and perhaps this is why I'm not getting any video transmission.
The gimbal anti-vibration rubber mounts are shot too, so I'll have to replace the plate assembly. So what else is knackered? Let's run the self-check and perhaps I can find a bit more. Battery in, power on, DJI Go 4 app loading, here we go. It looks like we have the GPS locked onto one satellite. Well, that's good. Well, overall status of the aircraft is abnormal. Let's see a detail on that. So we have gimbal gyroscope error, contact DJI support for repair. Well, let's hope not. Gimbal overloaded, gimbal restarting. I wonder why. Then we have an issue with the compass, but hopefully that can be sorted with calibration. And obviously we have no video transmission, but the rest of it looks fairly okay here. So let's dive right in and start stripping the bed. I'm using an ESD mat as I think it has been through hell already, and I wouldn't really like it to finish it off with static charges now. First, I'm removing these four screws using a H5, and I have a mat tray ready so I don't lose anything. Next, it's the two H5s at the back. Not sure why I've got this Velcro here, but it needs to go. Then we have four screws at the bottom of the craft. The last out of four has some kind of a resin in it, and I can't get my tool in unless I remove it. DJI's way of anti-tamper. I can remove these covers now, under which we have the last two screws securing the top body shell. Let's see if I can pop it off then. Slowly unclipping all the way around. Just need to be careful as there is a GPS module cable that I wouldn't like to rip off. There it is, simply pull it straight up. There is no other surprises, just clips. Taking my time to make sure I don't damage anything. Pull it forward and here we go, we are in. Now I can carefully disconnect these two ribbon cables which are linking the motherboard with the camera gimbal board. And the JSD connector next, which supplies the power. Here is my new gimbal plate. I'm trying to see which screws I need to remove next. Right, these two at the front and these two at the back. They're all Phillips head. Hang on a minute, I might be getting a bit ahead of myself. It looks like these two ribbon cables need to be disconnected before I remove the gimbal plate. But they've been secured on with this RTV gunk, so I'll have to carefully remove that first. Just slice through it on both sides and disconnect the ribbon. Any old magic will do as long as I don't damage anything. Back to the last two remaining screws then. My camera signal cable is in the way. That should have been connected to the gimbal board though. Hey, gimbal's off! And I can slowly walk off the gimbal board. Got it! Careful of the power connector though, don't want to rip that off. So my other half of the gimbal ribbon cable is here, and my camera signal cable should have been connected there. I've just noticed one of the side clips for the connector is damaged, so let me quickly correct that. Next, there is two Phillips head screws securing the gimbal to the mount. They need to go too. Now I have enough access to work on the gimbal itself, so I can start removing all the cover plates, taking a note of how the camera signal cable is routed. When I replace it, it needs to follow the exact same path. Now I've got some sort of a sticker here, covering over my screws. Another DJI's way of anti-tamper. The last screw for this cover is well hidden under this arm, but before I remove it, I need to remove this little shell first. There we go, it's coming off now. Turn it around, and that leaves me the last two pieces to remove, with two Phillips head screws in each. see where the cable goes. The second cover has a tricky hook on it and needs to slide off when removing. The cable leads us inside there now, where it would be connected to the CCD. Last two screws and we are in. I'll mark these two pieces with a marker pen somewhere on the edge. This is to make sure they will marry exactly as they were when assembled back together. So now I can separate the camera from the gimbal using a small scalpel. Gently pry it open. Disconnect the cable and we're ready to install a new one. I got mine from Amazon. Handle the new signal cable with extreme care and inspect it carefully with magnifying glass prior to installation, as these are really fragile and can be damaged very easily during the install or in transit if not packed carefully. Save yourself a job. Now I can connect the new cable to the camera, ensuring it is seated properly. Time to pop it back on. The camera board should be making nice contact with the heatsink there. But it looks like the Sharpie pen mark wasn't necessary after all, but it was a good practice anyway. I'll tidy the cable into the channel and carefully bend it down so I can slip on the plastic shell back on. Hook it on, fit the screws back in and the tool securing the camera on too, of course. Now I can move on to flat ribbon cable replacement. It only makes sense to do them both while the gimbal is stripped down. So remove the RTV and unclip the first connector. Following the cable, memorizing its path. Notice where it's glued onto the motor body with self-adhesive. Now it loops back on itself and splits into two ways. One of them supplies the yaw motor, so let's go ahead and remove that. And the other supplies the pitch motor. I'll disconnect that too. Right after, I remove this protective tape. There we go, pitch motor disconnected. Well, let's leave the old ribbon in for now, as it will show me how the new one is supposed to be routed. As you can see, connectors on the new cable are clearly marked with letters to guide you on where they go. So first I'm connecting P to a pitch motor. Peel off the backing to expose adhesive and gently stick the ribbon into the dedicated channel. Then fold it over itself so that the other branch of the cable just misses the pitch motor arm. Now that I'm familiar with the path, I can remove the old ribbon to make room for the new. Notice that the roll motor supply is threaded through a hole in a yaw motor, and that there is another double fold in the ribbon. Let's see if I can replicate that. Here we go. Now I can carefully thread the roll connection through the yaw motor arm with a little help of tweezers and connect the yaw motor, making sure it's seated right. Peel off the backing to expose adhesive and connect the roll connector to a roll motor. Stick the ribbon to the motor body, loop it right way around, making sure it's not twisted and has enough room to flex when motor arms will be in action. This is applicable to all three axes. Back to the camera signal cable. I'll slot it into the channel of a roll motor cover and refit the cover. This leads me to the yaw, where the cable also sits in dedicated channel, but I need to leave enough slack so that the yaw motor can operate without pulling on the cable. Once happy, I can fit the cover back on. Now I can carry on with the rest of the cable. It fits into the channel there, and the little shell makes it stay in place. Let's fit the tape back on as it was, straighten the signal cable, and fit the last motor cover. You might have noted some of these parts I'm fitting back on are not in the best shape, but I'm not too bothered about aesthetics at the moment, as I can always come back and replace these parts, once I know everything is working as it should. So a bit of tape will do for now. Now that I've finished messing about with the gimbal, it's time to whack it onto a new plate and throw it all back into the drawer, shall we? Remove the three screws securing the gimbal board to the old plate, fit the plastic bracket provided to the new one and transfer the board over. Once in place, I can thread the flex ribbon cable through a dedicated opening and secure the gimbal to the plate. I'm using screws provided in the pack. Connect the flex ribbon and the camera signal cable to the gimbal board and it's ready to be installed in the drawer. Thread the power cable through and carefully position the assembly in, paying attention to the two ribbon cables for the obstacle avoidance. Slowly walk it in and refit the four screws.
Then I can connect all the ribbons back in, starting with the one to the back. Then the power cable and the two at the front.
Right, we're nearly done. Let's put the cover back on, hooking on at the front first. And don't forget to connect the GPS cable back in, as it won't be too impressed when I power it on. I'm not going to fit any screws in the cover just yet. Test it first. Oh look, the gimbal is initializing and I have a video feed. Thumbs up for that. Well, let's see if it calibrates okay. Calibration successful. Now calibrate the compass and see if it flies.
Take off.
Oh yes, it does. So enjoy the footage captured with this drone and please like, share or subscribe. It really helps me to create more.